Hey, what's up guys? Pattycakes here. I've had a ton of people recently asking me to put together an advanced hunter movement guide for Destiny 2, and I'm really excited to finally give it a shot. Most of my talented D2 playing friends agree, movement is where the skill gap between good and great players really starts to shine. I can usually tell roughly how good a player is by watching about 30 seconds of their movement around a map and in gunfights. It's also one of those tells I pick up when I suspect someone might be cheating. If their aim is incredible but their movement is subpar, usually that's a sign that something fishy might be going on. When it comes to hunter movement specifically, you have three main tools that make up your movement toolbox, and you can combine the three together to make some incredible plays. These three are sliding, dodging, and jumping. Let's start first with sliding. In Destiny, you want to be sliding around the map pretty much at all times, especially when you're engaged with enemies. Sliding makes you much harder to hit than just walking or running. So if you slide into a lane, you're more likely to make your opponent miss while you're lining up your own shot. You'll see top players doing this regularly by slide sniping into popular lanes. To do this, you want to start sliding just before you reach the intended lane that you want to peek, and then you whip your camera around 90 degrees to take the shot. It takes a little practice to get the timing down, but if you can master this technique, you'll be a really frustrating player to play against. It's also important to learn the timing and distance of your slide animation. If you slide too far away from safety, you can get picked off before reaching cover. This is a mistake that myself and many friends of mine sometimes make when playing aggressively. It's easy to wait until you're just a bit too close to cover to start that slide, and then get traded out even if you do manage to get a kill. One tip that may help you when you're practicing sliding just the right amount is to always practice being just one shot away from cover. This means that if you slide out, you're close enough to duck back into cover after taking only one shot from an opponent. It's worth spending a little bit of time to practice the sliding distance. This probably comes as a surprise to literally no one, but sliding while using a shotgun is incredibly powerful too. Sliding with a shotgun is a great way to close the gap on a player so that you can get into range to either one hit them with your shotgun or at least line up a shotgun melee combo. There are some nuances to sliding that might go a little bit further than most players have experimented with, and that's sliding at specific angles to control your distance from an opponent. For example, you can close the gap on an enemy player by sliding close enough to them that they have to pull out a shotgun to defend themselves, but then you slide at an angle away from them while you still have your primary out aiming at them, so that they have an awkward distance where their shotgun won't do much to you and you can land a few easy headshots with your hand cannon to kill them. You perform this by running in one direction and then starting the slide animation, and then just as you start to slide, you whip your camera around in the direction that you want to aim. This maintains the original direction of your sliding, but gives you the freedom to aim wherever you need to in order to kill your opponent. The next technique is one of my absolute favorites, and it combines sliding and dodging together just after taking a shot. My favorite way to do this is to slide into a lane in order to hit a snipe, and just as I pull the trigger, I'll dodge out of there so that even if I do miss my shot, I'm a very hard target to hit. If you watch me playing on Twitch, you'll catch me doing this all the time. By the way, I do tend to stream on Twitch a few days each week. You can catch me live over at twitch.tv/pattycakespc. The other slide-dodge combo that you'll see very often from other high-level players is to slide towards an enemy with your shotgun, just close enough to land that one-hit kill, and then dodge backwards to avoid getting hit by their shot. This way, even if you barely miss that shotgun kill, you can swap to your primary weapon and finish off the kill with the damage you've already put in. The cool thing about dodging is that you can dodge in any direction, and it's important to keep this in mind when you're choosing how to move around a map. I prefer to use the gambler's dodge option most of the time in PvP, because it has a much better animation for using your dodge evasively. I love to run 100 mobility or equivalent with a lightweight weapon equipped so that I can have my dodge off of cooldown as often as possible. It's one of the best defensive tools in your kit, and you can use it to escape almost any situation. I should also mention here that when you're dodging, you can use a combination of your first-person camera and your directional control to alter what your dodge looks like to the enemy player. You'll see a lot of top players doing these wild camera swings while they combine their directional control with their camera control to throw off the opponent. Some players even do things like temporarily toggling their DPI up really high on their mouse while they're dodging just to make this effect even crazier. It's something that's really fun to practice with and implement into your gameplay. You can also use this combination of camera control and directional control to dodge around corners. I can't even begin to tell you how many times I've used this trick to save my life in Destiny and escape an almost certain death. Combining sliding, dodging, and jumping together can make you an incredibly evasive target as a hunter. Speaking of jumping, that's the next tool for us to cover. One of the things that makes hunter movement so devastating in PvP in the hands of a good player is our ability to change directions rapidly with our in-air double jump. So you can be jumping in the air towards someone, take a shot, and then instantly jump 180 degrees backwards or forwards to throw your opponent off. Combining this jumping ability with an Icarus mod on your weapon for in-air accuracy gives you the ability to dominate the sky and cause your opponent to pay attention to multiple horizontal planes of a fight. One of my favorite things to do while playing with a team is to push an angle together where my teammates slide down low and I jump high into a lane, so the enemy player has to choose if they want to challenge the high or the low player. If you and your teammates are all hitting your shots, performing this double or triple coordinated peek can almost guarantee that you win a gunfight. One important thing to note here is that although hunters play very well in the air, you don't want to over rely on jumping in duels, as you don't want to develop habits like jumping in the middle of an even gunfight or jumping out too far from covers so that you just become a hanging target that's easy to hit. I find jumping in a duel to be most effective when you already have your opponent low and they duck behind cover. You can then use your vertical space to see over the cover and finish the kill. You can also use your jumping abilities to float over doorways when you see an opponent pushing towards you. You can double jump over a door back and forth so that they aren't sure exactly where you are when they enter the room. This works really well with a shotgun or with a sniper where you go for a body shot and a melee combo. Another cool way to utilize your jumping abilities is to combine your jumping with the slide and dodge combo that we talked about a few minutes ago. So you can slide into someone with a shotgun, then dodge to the side or to the back, and then jump straight over their head and really throw off their tracking on you. This is especially effective against controller players since they typically can't turn fast enough to track your movement most of the time when you're forcing them to turn around 180 degrees. This is actually one of the reasons that I prefer strafe jump as my jump option most of the time. The aerial movement that you get from the side to side jumping is incredibly powerful. Jumping also gives you the potential for moving around the map lightning fast if you know how to use the map geometry to your advantage. I'm always on the lookout for two particular map features when I'm moving around a map. These are low ceilings and downward slopes. Let me explain how this works. So you can use your double jump to bounce yourself off of low ceilings to get a small speed boost. If you're in a long hallway with a low ceiling, you might be able to pull this off two or three times and build up some massive speed, especially if you're wearing something like stompies and using strafe jump. In a similar way, you can also use downward slopes on maps to propel your jump with some great timing. This is a little bit harder to pull off, but once you get a feel for it, you can really zoom around a map. You want to be scanning the map for downward slopes like staircases and ramps, and then you time your jump so that you land on the downslope, and then double jump again immediately so that the momentum boosts your jump much stronger than if you had just landed on flat ground. The trick here is to get your first jump as high in the air as possible so that you build up a lot of downward momentum thanks to gravity just as you hit your downslope. And then your first jump just as you hit the ground boosts you more sideways instead of upwards, and you follow that up with a very rapid double jump which propels your momentum forwards instead of up. I would recommend loading into a private match on each map and look for different spots where you can pull this off. It's a great way to rapidly rotate around a map, and it just takes a little bit of practice. It's certainly much faster than just running around the map. You do need to be careful, however, when you're doing this technique, because you're really opening yourself up to some danger flying around the map since it consumes your double jump and you won't have much directional control again until you hit the ground. It's best to only do this when you're pretty sure that you can rotate around an area safely without being shot at, or you're using this technique to get into a fight where your teammates are already engaged and they really need your help fast. There's one other movement technique that's not specific to hunters, but I think that it's worth mentioning here because it's something I see a lot of players doing wrong, and that's strafing. It's of course helpful to be strafing while you're in a gunfight to make yourself harder to hit, but I see a lot of players strafing with very predictable movement patterns. These players will move left and right in even amounts, and it's really easy to predict where their next move will be so that you can finish off the kill. What you want to do instead is to vary the amounts of side-to-side movement, so for example, if you normally would move 1 meter to the left, 1 meter to the right, your next left movement should be maybe 2 meters, and then 1 meter back to the right, and then 3 meters left, 2 meters right, etc. This makes you a lot harder to hit since it's a less predictable movement pattern. Also, be sure to throw in a few crouches to change your height. You don't need to do that crazy crouch macro you might see some players doing where you're rapidly going up and down, but if you just throw in a few crouches for each gunfight, you might force your opponent to miss a shot and give you the edge. One cool way to visualize this concept is to think about making a V pattern with your head as you move. You can make a series of Vs where you strafe, crouch, and pop up while strafing. You're trying to not crouch back up to where your head just was previously located a second ago, and you also don't want to be staying crouched in the same spot for too long, or strafing too long in a single direction. Spend some time practicing this in a private match and try it out in Rumble and see if you start winning your 1v1s a little bit more consistently with better movement than your opponent. One of the essential components to becoming a solid player is to always be a bit unpredictable. It's helpful to mix up your movement patterns by sliding corners versus jumping them sometimes and jumping them at various heights. You can jump up high, jump right at head level, or instead slide into a lane, and use different combos to make yourself a little bit less predictable so that your opponent doesn't know exactly what to expect. I also wanted to add a quick section here about movement during your super, specifically in the roaming supers with Arcstrider and Spectral Blades. One of the mistakes I see a lot of new players making too often is running at their opponents in a straight line. This makes you a really easy target to hit, and experienced players will snipe you out of your super really consistently. With Arc Strider, you want to utilize your dodge to make yourself really hard to hit while you close in on your target. You can dodge as many times as you want, so it makes sense to wiggle your mouse back and forth and dodge slightly to the left and right as you close the gap. There's also an advanced Arc Strider tip that more experienced players use frequently to duel other supers. You can perform a palm strike by doing a combination of light attack, heavy attack. I find the most effective way to use this technique while dueling other roaming supers is to bait them towards you by light attacking twice away from you, and then spin your camera 180 degrees towards them and heavy attack to hit them with that palm strike. It's a great way to guarantee a win on those janky super vs super duels. For Spectral Blades, your best bet is to close the gap by rapidly dashing to the left and right so that you make sort of a zigzag pattern while you're closing the gap. This makes you very hard to hit. Once you approach your target, you can either hit them with another light attack to finish the kill, or you can use a heavy attack to get the kill and then go back into stealth mode and find your next target. If you're dueling other supers with Spectral Blades, it works really well to hit them with a light attack, heavy attack combo. This often will allow you to get the kill since you can perform them pretty quickly back to back. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you master the combination of these techniques, you'll become a scary opponent to play against. If you did like this video, a thumbs up really helps my channel out. Also, let me know if you have any questions about these movement techniques in the comments. Be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss my next video. As I mentioned earlier, I do stream on Twitch a few days each week, and I'd love to chat with you while I'm live. You can catch me over at twitch.tv/pattycakespc. And finally, be sure to join our community Discord if you're looking for a cool place to meet some friends and play Destiny or really any other games with. We have over 1,000 members in there now, including players on each platform, so it could be a fun way for you to meet some other Guardians to play with. That's all for now. Catch you guys next time.